Hey guys, today I'm going to show you how to do this look right here. This is my go-to fall look. It has this gorgeous nude lip. It's like a darker nude lip, and I think this is the most wearable fall lip of the season. This is Velvet Teddy by MAC, and this is just what I've been wearing every day to work and to outside. It's just my go-to makeup look. And obviously now I threw on some lashes that made it a little bit more dramatic, but this look is totally wearable if you would remove the lashes. It is wearable wearing the lashes as well, but just remove the lashes if you want it to be a more of a daytime look. But I love this look so much, so I hope you guys enjoy this, and please subscribe, and I will show you more videos like this later.
So let's get started. I love how every time I decide to film, there's something on my face. My face has been doing so well lately that I just don't understand. The day I just, only time I have time to film, this happens.
So what we're gonna start with, if you guys are wondering, I don't know, I'll probably see it in the intro. I did dye my hair, so if you guys are wondering, I dye my hair basically for the fall, so I'm still getting used to what's happening all up in here, but we shall see.
So for foundation, getting ahead of myself,
to moisturize my face today was the 1006 formula 1006 shine free moisturizer. I do like this, but girls, it stinks. It does not smell good at all, but it keeps me matte like a move. So for primer today is one of my favorite primers from the drugstore. It is the Louis Magique L'Oreal primer. When I first started using this, I used it to be like dewy and stuff, but I have noticed it keeps my face looking flawless all day. Then for our foundation, I'm using my Revlon Color Stay in 330 Natural Tan. So I'm applying this with my Sedona Lace FB07 brush. And yeah, I'm gonna fast forward this. So that is applied. It might look a little weird now, but I just like to let it settle a little bit in my skin. I did realize that my brush had a little bit too much product on it, so it didn't apply it as smoothly as I like it, but it works. And if it doesn't look like it fits my neck, it does, but it's probably because my lighting is kind of off. I'm just gonna take a little bit of my beauty blender and kind of my beauty blender. This is my Real Techniques Miracle Sponge. I use it quite a lot. It's just like a cheap version of the beauty blender. Okay, right away I'm gonna go and do my under eye concealer because actually first I'm gonna apply my Select Cover Up Concealer from MAC. This is an NC35. Way too dark for my skin, but it still works. And I do apply it under my eyes because it has a really nice orange tint and it really hides my bags super well, which I like. It is a cream concealer, so it tends to like move around a lot, but you know, it works. It works! So what we're gonna do is I'm applying my NYX HD Concealer. This is in the color CW02. I did buy this way too light, and I can explain myself. I was running in and I felt like I didn't have any time, so I just ran in, got the second lightest one, which usually is the concealer that I use in all other concealers, but this one, way too light. So ignore that. I do blend it in later. Don't you worry. Don't you worry. So I'm just gonna apply that in a triangular shape. You can skip this step if you don't like it, if you think it's way too dramatic. Like you see, it feels like I'm applying white paint on my eyes. Don't worry. It's gonna be blended. And to balance out these eyes, you do also want to highlight your face. So I highlight the bridge of my nose there. Look like a clown. A little bit around my nostrils. On my cupid's bow, like that. On my chin. And on my
forehead. Using my fingers and pat that pink because a lot. I like to use my foot cleaners first. So I'm just gonna pat this in and blend it out. I'm gonna use my contour brush from Real Techniques. Blend it in.
I go in with my foundation brush just to blend everything out. I'm gonna use my favorite powder, which is the Stay Matte by Rimmel. This is in Silky Beige, and I'm using my powder brush from e.l.f. On the rest of the face, I'm using my MAC Mineralize Skin Finish in the medium deep. Let's move on to the eyes. I'm gonna start by using my NYX eye base in the skin color.
I'm gonna apply that all over my eye, also under and everywhere.
So the eyeshadow palette I'm using today is NYX Love in Paris eyeshadow palette in Merci Beaucoup. Anyways, I bought this palette the other day and I'm in love with it. I think it's perfect for fall. It has the perfect colors here. And I'm not going to use all these colors today. I'm just going to use a few because I've been using these every day. So this is my go-to palette. I'm going to start by taking my fluffy brush and actually not use any of these colors. I'm going to start with a transition shade, and I'm going to use my favorite transition shade from the Oh So Special palette. It's almost running out. I need to get a new one.
Straight into my crease here. Really easy.
Then we're going to take my favorite brush from Sedona Lace. This is the EB09. It's just a really nice blending brush. And I'm going to be taking, this is my favorite color. And here is this camel color. I don't know if it has a name. It does not. It's just a really nice camel brown. Camel brown. Just a really nice brown. And I'm just going to take that at the tip of my brush, tap off the excess. And I'm gonna tip my brush like so, and I'm gonna apply it like this.
Be concentrated, so I'm just gonna blend that into my crease now.
I feel like I'm too far from you guys. I'm just gonna move you in a tiny bit closer. So I'm just applying this warm brown into my crease here. Make sure you blend it as much as you can. Now all over the lid, I'm gonna apply a mix of these two colors right here. It's just two very nice champagne-y colors. I'm applying that with my finger.
Just packing those colors on as well as I can.
Now we're gonna go in with this matte brown, charcoal brown here, mixing it with this brown right here, which is a little bit of a shimmery brown. And I'm gonna apply it using this pencil brush here from Icy Paris. And we're gonna apply it into kind of a cut crease. So look down in your mirror, and the easiest way to do this is take a mirror, look down into the mirror, and you'll see the crease, and just apply it into the crease. Sorry, my camera died, so let's get back. So I'm just using that cream color and I'm putting it under my brow bone with this fluffy brush from Essence of Beauty. Now what we're gonna do is apply our liner. I'm just gonna use my, oh no I'm not, sorry guys. I'm gonna use my NYC liner.
First, apply the liner on my lash line.
So next, what I'm gonna do is take my Rimmel Scandal Eyes Waterproof Liner. This is in black. And I'm just gonna tight line. Okay, Okay, on the bottom liner, I'm gonna apply my usual Essence Nude Liner. I'm gonna go off camera now and apply my mascara. I'm just using two mascaras. I'm using the Maybelline Cat Eyes Colossal Volume Express Mascara. This is the Cat Eye one. And then my telescopic, false lash telescopic, the silver one from L'Oreal. So,
be right back.
As you guys can see, I did decide to apply some falsies. I did film this actually, but it went to an absolute disaster. It just did not work out, so I'm not gonna put the footage. And now we're gonna balance out the bottom lash line, obviously, because we have so much heaviness up on top here. So we're gonna take our little handy dandy NYX Love in Paris palette, and we're gonna start by taking this camel color again with a nice tiny brush. This is the EB21, and we're gonna apply it under our eyes. Like so, we're taking our fluffy brush and we're gonna just blend that out. Try not to poke yourself in the eye. Do that a lot of friendly. And we're gonna do our face. First, we're gonna use our e.l.f. contour and blush palette in St. Lucia. We're gonna use the contouring shade with the stippling brush from e.l.f.
Quite a contour, but we're actually not gonna apply a contour. I'm not expecting it. We're just gonna apply this on our cheeks and blending it down to our neck and on our temple. And up on here.
We're gonna take a blush from e.l.f. as well. This is Twinkle Pink. I'm gonna apply that with our angle brush from Icy Paris and right on our cheeks. Nothing. This is the Catrice Bronzing Highlighter Pen, and I actually love to use this as a highlighter. So what I do is just I put it on my finger because it's just the easiest way, and I apply it here. As you guys can see, it's just a gorgeous highlight. Now, that actually is quite intense, but you know.
Now, time for the star of the show is our lips. I'm creating. Sorry, there's some obnoxious kids outside screaming. Okay, not obnoxious, kids are lovely.
Anyways, let's talk about this. So, I went into MAC and I kind of went out on a limb and I wanted a nice fall color. My first thought was like, okay, I'm gonna get Rebel, Diva, something like that, something dark, something berry, just something fall-like, vampy kind of thing. But I actually decided to get a dark nude. So I decided to get this color right here. This is Velvet Teddy. It is a matte nude or darker nude. It's like a brownie nude. And guys, I cannot begin to tell you how much I adore this lipstick. It is one of the most amazing lipsticks I've ever bought. I am so in love with this. I think it fits my complexion perfectly. But the best part about this lipstick is you can apply it and then it fades out into your lips during the day, so you don't really have to reapply it because it doesn't ever look faded or anything. It just looks like your normal lips. So I'm gonna apply this, and I do apply this Kylie Jenner style. I do go over my lips a little bit because this is actually a perfect lipstick to do that. It is like, this actually is not a bad Kylie Jenner like lipstick. I think she uses like Whirl lip liner by MAC, and I think this is a pretty good color too if you like Kylie Jenner's lips. So let's apply. And we're done. We're gonna let our hair down and we're gonna close those a little.